Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Rama Dhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Gopi Jana Balava Girivara Dhari प्रभुपाद की भुवन मंगल हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय श्रीमद्भागवतम की गौर प्रेमानंदी ओम अज्ञानतिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमावं विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिने इति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणी निर्विशेष सुन्नवादी पाश्चात्य देशकारिणी वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि श्रीगौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नारायणं नमस्कृतं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जय मुदीरयेत् मुखं करोति वाचालं पङ्गुलं हैतगिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधवं श्रीगुरुदिनचरणं श्रीचैतन्येश्वरं So Bhagavatam states, those that take shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, Samasrita Jai Padapallava Plabang Mahat Padang Punna Jasamurare. Samasrita, Samyak Asrita, complete shelter under the lotus feet of Murari, Mahat Padang Jasamurari, Bhavambuddhi Vascha Padang. The Bhavambuddhi, the ocean of material existence. Bhava Ambudhi. Bhava means material world. Ambu means water. Ambudhi means ocean. That vast ocean of material existence that becomes like a hole, small hole, made by hoof print of a calf. So devotee can easily cross over. If you are walking on the street, there is a hole made by hoof print of a calf. What do? You jump over it? Many of you have not seen the hoof print of calf, because in America you don't see any calf here. How to speak of hoof print of the calf? In America they don't like to see the soil also. Always they like to cover the soil, right? Everywhere peach, tars. And there is tree, they cover with wood also there. They don't like soil somewhere. So a hoof print of calf is so small that you don't have to jump over it. Right? You can walk, you don't recognize also. Somebody takes shelter of Krishna is like that. Babam Buddhi Bascha Padang. Why don't you take a chair? You'll take a chair? Huh? Okay? Bring a chair for Prabhu. Bascha Padang Parang Padang 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 Jad Bipadang Nate Sang. This material world, you go there, sit there. On that sofa. Somebody can help him. Okay, he'll help right here. Padang padang jat vipadang na tesang. Those that take shelter of lotus feet of Murari, though this material world is filled with dangers at every step, but his devotees they overcome. Very easily. So many of you may not know that how Jaya Gaur Sundar Prabhu has overcome a big danger in his life. You know what has happened to Prabhu? He just went through a open heart surgery. How many of you know this? Nobody knows. He went through a open heart surgery. But nobody knew it. So today maybe his first day, we are knowing. He went through this surgery. That's why he's feeling weak, not to sit on the floor. The point is, the devotees that take shelter at the lotus feet of Dasa Murari, Mahat Padang. So in this way, we can overcome though this material world is Padang padang jat vipadang. Every step there is danger. And of course for those they have taken shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna, whether free of danger or with danger, both they take as same. For outside people, when they are protected, it is not protection. But for devotees, they're protected, if not protected, they're also protected. That's why we say, Krishna rakhyateti vishwas. If Krishna protects, we have full faith. Krishna will protect. But devotees, they say, Krishna, you protect or you don't protect? You are my master. Krishna rakhyateti vishwas, na rakhyateti vishwas. With Krishna's protection, not protection, both we are protected in any state of life. That's why we take shelter of Krishna, irrespective of dharma, adharma, papa, punya, or anything. So we'll just read briefly, we'll discuss something 15-20 minutes on a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam. As you know, in this Kali Yuga, Srimad Bhagavatam is incarnation of Krishna. In Kali Yuga, Lord, He does not incarnate in Kali Yuga. Kali Kale Nam Rupe Krishna Avatar. He incarnates in the form of the holy name, Nama Brahma, and the form of Srimad Bhagavatam, Sabda Brahma. Two things. And you should know Srimad Bhagavatam is the ultimate knowledge, ultimate teachings of Vedic literatures. So what Srimad Bhagavatam is teaching us, so let us know, okay? So first canto, first chapter, as in tobacco, we discussed the first verse. Today briefly I will tell you about the second verse, very interesting. Dharma prajjita kaitavatra parama nimascharanang satang veddang vastavam atravastu sivadam tapatra unmulanam Srimad Bhagavate Mahamanikrite Kingba Paraiswara Saddarudha Avarudha Tatra Krutavi Sushrusubhi Tatkhanat Saddarudha Avarudha Tatra. Srimad Bhagavatam is such a pure literature. Srimad Bhagavatam Amalam Pramanam Prema Pumarthaman. Amal. Amal means no mal. No contamination is there. Free from all kinds of contamination. Srimad Bhagavatam Amalam Puranam Jad Vaishnavanang Priya. Very dear to Vaishnav. Jasmin Paramhansam Ekam Jnanam Param Gyate. Here the knowledge given which is meant for Paramhansas. Jatra Jnana Viraga Bhakti Naiskarmam Abhiskritam. Only pure bhakti. No jnana, no karma. So if somebody listen it regularly, jat srunung supathana vicharana para bhaktya vimuchyanara, he can overcome the cycle of birth and death by regularly hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. And Srimad Bhagavatam is such a powerful literature. This other Vedic literature, you have to listen. You have to understand. You have to follow in your life. Then you get result. But Srimad Bhagavatam is such a powerful literature. What to speak of? You listen, you understand, you follow. Srimad Bhagavatam is such a literature that even if you don't get opportunity to hear, you are sitting in your house just thinking, oh, how nice it would be, I could hear Srimad Bhagavatam. Saddha Rudyat Krutvi Sushrusubhi. Sushrusubhi, just by developing desire to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, one can arrest the Supreme Personality of Godhead within his heart. That much power this literature has. Just imagine, if you carefully listen it, understand and follow, what result one will get. So, the interesting in this verse is, saying dharma prajjita kaitava, that one must reject all religious activities. Bhagavad Gita, where Bhagavad Gita ends, Srimad Bhagavatam starts from there. What is the last verse of, last teachings in Bhagavad Gita Krishna giving us? What is the conclusive teachings in Bhagavad Gita Krishna has given us? What? Sarvadharman Paritejya? Okay. Have you analyzed this verse? Krishna coming to this material world, why he is coming? What are the reasons he has told in Gita? Paritrinaya sadhanang vinashaya dharma sansthapanarthaya. So Krishna tells everybody, I am God, I have come, I will teach you dharma. So everybody gathers. So Krishna explains everything nicely. But at the end, what he is saying? Sarva dharman paritejya. Krishna wants everybody surrender unto me, that is very good. Mahamekam saranam braja, no problem. But Krishna not saying sarva adharma paritejya mahamekam saranam braja. Would not it be nice? Any problem? Sarva adharma paritejya mahamekam saranam braja. That would be better. Or sarva dharma paritejya, that would be better. Have you heard any literature, any sadhu sannyasi saying, give up dharma, give up pious activities. The first time you will see in Bhagavad Gita conclusive, he's saying sarva dharma paritejya. Dharma means not saying that Muslim, Christian dharma become all Hindu. But that time there is no Muslim, Christian, Hindu things, concept. But Krishna, who came to establish dharma, in conclusion he's saying you give up dharma. No. So that is the end of teachings of Bhagavad Gita. Very bewildering statement. If people will not meditate, analyze it, they'll just go, sarva dharma paritejya. Do you analyze it? What is talking about? Sarva dharma paritejya? You could have told sarva dharma paritejya mamakam saranam braja. But here we find that dharma is also obstacle as much as adharma. That subtle obstacle people they don't understand. So Krishna wants to make that point very clear. Sarva dharma paritejya mamakam saranam braja. So that verse has been clarified in Bhagavatam at the beginning. Bhagavat ends sarva dharma paritejya, Bhagavad Gita ends with sarva dharma paritejya, and Bhagavatam starts with dharma prajjita. Dharma prajjita, completely rejected religiosity. Bhagavat completely rejected religiosity. Because it's kaitava, it's cheating. It's cheating religious. Religious mentality is cheating process to bewilder us, to make us stuck in this material world. That's why when Vyasadeva was not very happy, even if after writing Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, Purana, sitting on the bank of Saraswati River, feeling very sad. His Gurudev Narada Muni came, why you look so sad? He said, Gurudev, I don't know. For the welfare of the human society, I wrote Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, Purana, but I don't understand why I'm not so happy. I feel something lacking. Then Narada Muni said, what? For the welfare of the human society, you have written all the literatures? Don't you know? By writing all the literatures, where you have described up the dharma so elaborately, you have closed the door for the people to go back to Godhead. In the name of dharma, you have cheated people. You are incarnation of God. So if you give so much importance to dharma, so people will just run after dharma. And what dharma is meant for? The dharma is meant for artha. Why people are engaged in dharma? Why there are big line in the temple in India? Of course, big line in the temple of Kali, Shiv, Durga, Ganesh, big line. Vishnu temple, not much line there. One Vishnu temple, big line, that's Tirupati Baba. Because he gives money. So much so people that do business, make partnership to Tirupati Balaji. But the purpose of dharma is only to get artha, economic development. And when you get economic development, lot of money, what to do with that? Give to ISKCON, donation. Then immediately, you'll run for buying nice mobile phone, nice television, nice house. Where I get it from? Dharma, artha. Then you engage in fulfilling your material desires. Dharma, artha, kama. Then when kama is such a thing, material desire is such a thing, na jato kama kaman upabhagyan sammate. Your desire for sense gratification will never be subdued by engaging in sense gratification. Just like in fire, if you pour ghee, any time will come, fire will say, oh, I am full stomach, I don't need any more ghee. More ghee you put, fire will burn more and more, like that. So what Bhagavad is teaching us? Dharma prajjita kaitava. This cheating dharma. Kaitava means cheating. Dharma sahi apavargasa nartha artha upakalpate. The purpose of dharma is not to get economic development. Apavargasya, purpose of dharma is to get higher destination of the life. So dharma prajjita kaitava atra parama nimascharanam satam. And Prabhupada translating, completely rejecting all religious activities. All religious activities. Everybody, irreligious people, religious people. Everybody thinking religious activities better than irreligious activities. That is true. Religious activities, pious activities better than sinful or irreligious activities. But that is not the end of the day. So higher than religious activities, spiritual activities. So there is the personal pleasure and personal activities. My personal pleasure is when I eat one rasgola. My personal pleasure. One kind of pleasure activity. Then parivarik ananda, that is family activities. All the activities going with our family, we are enjoying. Then the social activities. Go to the club, all kinds of activities, social activities. Then beyond social activities, religious activities. So most of the people, they are happy when personally they become happy, pass. Then some people, they extend to family happiness. Many people are not into family happiness. No. Then some people get family happiness. My family happy, that's it. I don't care what happening to society. Then some people go one step ahead. Social activities, social happiness, okay? Then some people, they go one step beyond that, called religious activities. Kali Puja, Durga Puja, Ganesh Puja, they're all religious activities, doing yajna, religious activities. Then beyond religious activities, spiritual activities. Many people, they're not interested in the spiritual activities. And within spiritual activities, there are different kinds of spiritual activities. There are jnanis, striving for nirakar brahma. There are yogis, they are doing meditation for realizing paramatma. Then there are devotees, the devotional activities. So there are different stages of activities by which we derive different kinds of pleasure. Personal pleasure, family pleasure, social pleasure, religious pleasure, spiritual pleasure, on top of everything is devotional life, devotional pleasure. So that is what Bhagavatam is speaking about, bhakti. So in bhakti, there are different kinds of bhakti. There is sakama bhakti. What is sakama bhakti means? Sakama bhakta, they worship God. They accept God, the devotee of God. But what for the devotee of God? Sakam Bhakta. They want to get something from Bhagavan. Give me dhanam dehi, janam dehi, jasam dehi. They want to get from Bhagavan. That is Sakam Bhakta. With some kamana, some material motivations. Then the Niskam Bhakti. Niskam Bhakti means whether you give or you don't give, you are my Lord. I don't care whether you give or you don't give. You are my master. It's called Niskam Bhakti. The next is Sakam Bhakti, Niskam Bhakti. Next is Prema Bhakti. Prema Bhakti. Sakam Bhakti, you give me. Niskam Bhakti, whether you give, you don't give, it's okay. Prema Bhakti means? Guess what it could be? What Prema Bhakti could be? If Sakam Bhakti you give me, Niskam Bhakti you give or you don't give, okay. So what would be Prema Bhakti?
Serving God of love. Serving God of love.
Prema Bhakti means I will give you. What do you give me? I will give you. So that is what Bhagavad is speaking. One who will learn the teachings of Bhagavatam, he will be eligible for this. That Supreme Personality of Godhead who gives everybody. If you read Bhagavatam, you will be eligible to give to God. Not only you will become only eligible to give to God, God will run behind you to get from you. That is what Bhagavan is saying. I am Atmaram. I am ever satisfied. Aptakama. But when my devotee walks on the street with tulasi and water, I feel very hungry. I run behind my devotee. Please, please, I am hungry. Give some water to me. You understand how powerful the teachings of Bhagavatam? Where is the question of doing something to get something? Worshipping demigods, doing some yajna. You, one look capable of giving to God, that is prema bhakti, that God will run behind us, behind his devotee. So that is what ISKCON temple is meant for, giving teaching Bhagavatam. In India we have thousands of temples, Hindu temples, and thousands of people are going visiting. Now ISKCON opening so many new temples, big temples, thousands of people going there also. So what is the difference? There are God in all other temples and God in ISKCON temples. What is the difference between the gods? Outside temple, all gods are sitting there to give you. If you go, they will give you. They are all Denawala Bhagavan. But ISKCON Bhagavan is Lenawala Bhagavan. He will take it from you. He will not get scared. Oh, he will take away everything. But yes, he will take away. He will take from you. So that principle is taught here. Dharma, Prajita, Kaitava. All these religious propensities are simply cheating, where the people running behind God just to get something. But Bhagavata has rejected that. Prajita has rejected that. Bhagavata is teaching something that you will feel to give to God. You like to give to God. Which are met. This Bhagavata Puran profounds the highest truth, which is understandable by those devotees who are fully pure in their heart. Dharma parama nimascharanang satang. Nimascharan, 100% pure. For those people, they can feel to give. Nimascara. What is Nimascara? Nimascara word have you heard? Mascharya? Mascharya? The word have you heard?
Envy.
Not hatred.
Envy.
Mascharya means jealous. Envious, jealous. Envy. That means asuya means if you see somebody else getting good, you are burning. Wow, no? You are suffering to see others growing, developing nicely, no? You are getting 1 lakh rupees. Somebody getting 1 lakh 50,000 rupees, you will not be happy. But you are getting 20,000 rupees, no problem. If somebody getting 10,000 rupees, no problem. Our source of pleasure is like this. Mascharyata. Mascharya means enviousness. How poor I am does not matter. No. But how poor my neighbor is, that does matter to me. In this regard, one story I remember in Orissa, there's one tantric. The source of happiness in this material world, I'll tell you. What is real? Where it arises from, our pleasure. The tantric, he used to do betal sadhana, one kind of tantra. So he went to forest. He did some sadhana, then he got siddhi. So that betal, that ghost came. I'm very happy with you. Please tell me what boon you want. So this man told, please you bless me. Whatever I want, I'll get it. Then Betal said, Tathastu. Whatever you want, you'll get it. So by hearing this, he was very happy. Then he said, Betal said, but whatever you get, your neighbor will get double than you. But this man was so happy by hearing whatever he'll think he'll get, the second line he did not hear properly. So he was very happy, whatever he merited he'll get. So he went to his village. See, in village, everybody have a straw house. So nowadays, I don't know what is in America, but in India, if somebody can build on building, na pakka building, then it, oh, my human life is successful. I build a house, no, in my life. So village man, so first he went to his house meditating. Oh my God, give me two-story building. So immediately he got two-story building. He was happy, but you don't become happy when you get it. You get something, you don't become happy. You know when real happiness comes? You know? When you show it to others, then real happiness comes. You get a nice car. So anything, let my friends see this. Like women, they put nice dress, nice ornaments, they will sit inside the room, they will be happy. They will go out, so you just see. So our happiness is not how much I get. Our happiness, how much I show to others. By seeing me, they will be burning. So then I feel very happy. So this man, he got a two-story building. But to get real happiness, you see, real happiness will come. In village, everybody they have straw house. You get two-story building means you show everybody. If somebody will get two-story building in Manhattan, will he become happy? No, he's the poorest person there, Manhattan two-story building. But this man, then he went out of the room, out of his house, to show everybody, just see, I have two-story building. But what he saw? Neighbor has four-story building. He was born, he was not happy. He got two-story building, but neighbor has four-story building. He's not happy. Then he went inside the room, again meditation. Oh, Betal, give me four-story building. He got a middle four-story building. Went out, neighbor has eight-story building. In this way, he's trying to get as much as opulence, but whatever he gets, neighbor getting double than that. So neighbor he was happy. The master, he's getting so much. More he gets, more he suffers. More he gets, more he suffers. Why? Because the neighbor is getting double. So never happy. So finally one day, he got some intelligence how to become happy. And he's thinking, okay, whatever I get, my neighbor will get double than me. Okay. And he's meditating, oh Betal, please you make my one eye blind. So his one eye become blind. Then he went outside, the neighbor, two eyes are blind. He was very happy, wow, finally I got something, no? So my point is, this is the happiness in this material world, mastaryata. So what this is saying, you are pure means, we have no mastaryata. Pure heart means, when we don't become happy by getting things, when we become happy by giving things. In this material world, source of our pleasure is two things. If I get, I feel happy. And second thing is, only if I get, that's not sufficient. I may get, but my neighbor getting less than me, then I am happy. Otherwise, I am not happy. So, the pure-hearted people means, not how much I get, but how much I can give. So this is the fundamental principles being practiced in spiritual world. Spiritual world is a world for giving, not for getting. That everybody competing. How much I can give? Here everybody competing, how much I can take? Now how can I empty out others' pockets? That is success of my life. You cannot empty out others' pockets, then you are unsuccessful in this material world. You are a foolish person. But Bhagavad teaching us the love. Love means how much we give to others. How much we give to Krishna. Dharma prajjita kaitavatra parama nimascharanang satang. The Bhagavatam can be well understood by those people who are fully pure in their heart. fully pure in our heart means we don't become envious of others. We don't run after others to get, rather we run after everybody to give them. We don't run after God to get from God. We'll run after God to give to God. We'll run after God to give to God. Not only that, God will run after us. God will run after His devotee. So they are pure hearted. So Vedam Vastavam Atarvastu Sivadam Tapatre Unmalanam. By Srimad Bhagavatam, we understand the absolute truth, Vastava Vastu. Sivadang, the factual, here describes Sivadang, very auspicious. Siva means auspicious. If every day we read Srimad Bhagavatam, it will bring auspiciousness to our house and tapatraya unmalanam. Tritap klesa will be rooted out, will become free. We have four kinds of sufferings in this material, problems in this material world. All of you know that. What are the four kinds of problems in your this material world? Four problems. Birth, death, old age. That dukkha dosanudarsanam. Janma mrtu jarabyadhi. Dukkha dosanudarsanam. These are the real dukkha. And also there is tritap klesa. Three kinds of misery. Adhyatmik, adhibhautik, and adhidaivik. The sufferings we are deriving from ourselves. Headache, fever, like that. Adhyatmik. Adhibhautik, from other living entities. Snake biting, mosquito biting. You have no mosquitoes in America. You have? In India, we have so much mosquitoes. Always adhibhautik lesa is there. Then adi daivik, from devatas, daiva, so much flood, tsunami, earthquake, everybody you have to face. Tapatraya unmalanam. If we hear this Srimad Bhagavatam, we become free from the cycle of birth and death, and we become free from tritap klesa. Srimad Bhagavate Mahamuni Krita Kingba Parahiswara. The Srimad Bhagavat compiled by Srila Vyasadev. Srimad Bhagavat which was spoken by Chatush Kumar. If somebody has Srimad Bhagavatam Mahamunik the Kingba Paraiswara, then we do not need any other things. Srimad Bhagavatam gives us all the benedictions in our life. That's why it has been instructed to make our life successful. Nityang Bhagavat Sevaya Bhagavati Uttam Sloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naisti. That we should do, read every day Srimad Bhagavatam so that our bhakti will become fixed. We have Anishtita Bhakti and Nishtita Bhakti. And our bhakti is Anishtita Bhakti. But we have to bring it to the level of Nishtha. We have Shraddha, we have faith, but there is Komala Shraddha and Dridha Shraddha. Our faith is very fragile, very soft, but we have to make it very strong. And these things will happen. Nityang Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttam Slake Bhaktir Bhavati Naistiti. If every day we listen, our heart, so much anarthas are there, unwanted desires, but that will be removed by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. Anartha Upasamam Sakhyat Bhakti Yoga Madhakshaje. By engaging in devotional service, the anarth will be eradicated. But we do not know how to engage in devotional service. So Bhagavat teaches us, Lokasya Ajanata Vidyang Chakra Sastrata Sanghita. The people that don't know, Vyasadeva compiled Bhagavatam. Jasya Vaishya Manayam Krishna Parampurasya Bhakti Rutvadate Punsa Soka Mahabhayapaha. How I shall develop bhakti unto Krishna? Here is saying how. So by hearing Srimad Jasyang Vaishya Manayam Krishna Parampurasya Bhakti Utpadate, bhakti will arise onto the lotus feet of Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, then Soka Moha Bhayapaha, or Soka lamentation, bewilderment and fear will be eradicated. This will bring perfection to our human life. So So we have to learn to make our life successful. The principle is to give. Because Bhagavatam teaches about prema, prema pumarthamahan. As prema and opposite to prema is? What is opposite to prema? Kama. Kama. Kama and prema. And spiritual world prema. Material world there is no prema. Material world there is no love. I may say, oh, I love you so much. I don't love you so much. I lust on you so much. Actually, all of us should say, oh, I lust on you so much. Wrongly you are telling, pretending, I love you so much. We are simply lusting on each other. How much I'll get from you? You give me, okay, good love. You don't give me, okay, good luck. That is the real nature of this material world. You cannot avoid it. You can pretend so much, oh, I love you, I love you. Love you, then when your time comes, talak, 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 bas, finish. Love is finished. But spiritual world is not like that. Spiritual world is best, not what I get from you, but how much I can give you. So that is very, very important. That if you have to give to somebody, we should give to Krishna. We should give to God. And if you jasmin tushta jagat tushta, if God is satisfied, everything will be satisfied. Thank you so much. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki, Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Everybody must be feeling very hot here. Huh? Feeling hot, okay? Okay. Yes.
We heard about how Srimad Bhagavatam is very beneficial. We heard about how Srimad Bhagavatam is beneficial for us. But at the same time, we also heard that only people who are non-envious can understand Srimad Bhagavatam. So there's both correct statements.
Nityang Bhagavat Sevaya Bhagavat Uttam, regularly, then Tada Rajas Tama Bhava Kamalabha Dayasaja Cheta Itar Anabhidam Stitam Satya Prasada. Tada means at that time, then Kama Lobha, you know, which arises from Rajaguna, will not penetrate to your heart. You will be situated in mood of goodness. Stitam Satya Prasidati. You will feel very blissful. That time gradually, our envious nature will go away. Then we engage in devotional service with a blissful mood. Evam prasanna manasa bhagavat bhakti jagata bhagavat tattva vijnana mukta sangasa jayate. So Bhagavatam is meant for Paramahansa. Bhagavata can bring ordinary people to Paramahansa level also. So both it will work. So no problem. Anybody can take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Yes. But you talked about differentiating adharma and dharma, religion and irreligion, and trying to develop our spiritual practice. And sometimes it seems in this day and age that the term religion is used very loosely, and sometimes there are similar qualities of religion and spiritual practices. Is it okay if we try to strive for spiritual practice but follow a religion per se? In doing so?
Yes, religious principles should be followed. You see, the religious principles should be followed. That is called varnasrama. According to varna and ashram, following the instructions of scriptures when you maintain a life, that is called religious. There are two kinds of varnasrama, one sakkama varnasrama and niskama varnasrama. You follow all religious principles, everything perfectly, then you will be promoted to higher planetary systems. Strong brahmachari, strong, good grihastha, A-class grihastha, you go to heaven. Then very good brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, then you go to more higher planetary, like this. It is called sakam varnasram. But by doing religious activities, whatever you are getting, if you engage in Krishna service, there is Niskama Varnasram. Niskama Varnasram. So So that is what you should do. You should not act in irreligious way. You should act in a religious way, but give result to Krishna. So that is what Krishna is teaching. Krishna is not promoting you do irreligious activities. But when you become very Paramahansa level, you don't distinguish what is religious, what is irreligious. You just work for the satisfaction of Krishna. Na dharma, na adharma, sutigana, niruktam, kila kuru. In Shruti Shastra, so much dharma, adharma explanations are there. Very elevated, they don't care whatever it is. They simply engage in service of Krishna. Whether dharma or adharma, if they do adharma, go to hell, no problem for us. Let me Krishna satisfied. Take Braja Gopikas. Krishna told, who is my greatest devotee? Narada Muni went to Brahma, Shiva. Krishna said, now you test whoever gives the dust and put it on my head, then he is my devotee. And who can dare? Brahma, Shiva, everybody, they denied. Then Krishna told, you go to Braja Gopikas. Then Narada Muni said, Krishna has having headache, fever. What can you do? Krishna said, if anybody loves him, give dust of their feet, then he put on his head, fever will be cured. Then all Braja Gopikas collect all the dusts. Okay, please take this dust. Narada said, you are really foolish village girls. Why? Are Brahma, Shiva, they did not dare to give the dust and you are giving, foolish people. You know what will happen to you? If your dust will, Krishna will push his Param Brahma, Bhagavan. What will happen to us? Or you will go to hell? Oh, really? So fortunate? Oh, very good, very good. We will go to hell. They had no consideration of Papa Punna. We don't care for Papa Punna. We don't will go to hell or hell. That's a different level, not our level. We don't go to hell. So that's why we do religious activities and give result to Krishna. That is where we should take it. Krishna is not promoting irreligious. He is saying, don't get stuck with religious only, that is something beyond the spiritual, devotional. Okay, nice. So,
Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama.